Hello from Hopwood Hall. Today I have some fantastic news. A lot of you remember a few years ago we had some flagstones stolen from one of our gardens, but I have a very exciting update. But before I share that with you, don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and click the bell to be alerted about our latest content. And if you can join us on Patreon, please do, because we show a lot of exclusive videos there. Thanks. Now, many of you may recall that in November of 2020, we had a serious robbery here at Hopwood Hall, where thieves showed up in the darkness of night during the pandemic, and they stole centuries-old flagstones from this beautiful garden. This was not only devastating to me, but also the entire community, who saw this as a place of respite, an important part of the hall, and many of their ancestors had hand-laid those stones in that garden. The flagstones were assembled in an unusual configuration, and they were very different from many of the flagstones that are in the area. So we thought perhaps tracking them down might be a possibility. These aren't stones that someone just took for the sport of it or for the fun of it. It was to resell them or use them in their own home or perhaps give them to a friend to reinstall them. Shortly after the incident, BBC Crime Watch covered the crime, and a nationwide plea and search went out for the thieves who stole the stones. Today, the Greater Manchester Police are here to revisit the scene of the crime. All right, I wanted to introduce you to Stuart. This is Stuart. He is our protector, the local Greater Manchester Police. They're doing an incredible job. So just if you see Stuart, please say hello. So yeah, I wanted to show you what the community's been doing since the flagstones have been stolen. We're preparing this, the old pad where the flagstones were that were stolen, to prepare that so that we can, when we get our flagstones back, well, when you recover our flagstones. Okay, we just got a call from the police and they have found some flagstones. They think they have recovered some of our flagstones. So we're gonna go over there and identify them and hopefully return them to the hall. I'm just waiting on Jerry. She's finishing her cup of tea up at the hall, but as soon as she's here, off we go. So we're not sure if they're the actual flagstones that were taken from Hopwood Hall, but they're flagstones from the area, they're historic, and they said no one has claimed them so that we can come and pick them up. Okay, so here are the flagstones. There's not a whole lot of them, but it's some, it's a start. I don't know how we're gonna lift this. Yeah, that's really heavy. Just thinking slide them onto the wood and then up.
That's what I'm thinking.
We've just loaded the pieces of flagstone into the van, way heavier than anybody expected. I mean, one of them, I feel like it must have weighed a couple hundred pounds, maybe 300-400 pounds. It took five of us to lift it. All right, we're back at the hall now. We've got the flagstones in the van and we're gonna start unloading them.
Right.
It's just a simple matter of walking it over.
The weight of the stones makes you wonder how the heck did the thieves do it? Clearly they must have been professional criminals with equipment.
All right, I had to turn on the camera right away to let you guys know that I just got a phone call from Stuart and they have made an arrest. So I couldn't be happier to know that a lead has been found after all this time. The police have made a discovery that has led them to believe that this is the guy who stole Hopwood Hall's flagstones. So they showed up at his house early this morning. So we will keep you posted as we learn more. I just want to thank you because this is so cool to actually have potentially what could be some of the original stones back at the hall. So I really appreciate your hard work and your entire police department. It's really exciting. You guys are great and we thank you. Yeah. All right, here he is, PC Ockwell.